Welcome at my channel Acreates, the channel for game tutorials and more. In this tutorial, we explain how you can implement a double jump in Game Maker. We will only use drag and drop. First, we'll create separate sprites for the animations. I use the platform sprite from Kenney. Input the two sprites for the walk to the right into the sprite manager. We will duplicate this new sprite and rename it as animation left. Open this new sprite and select edit image. We want to mirror all frames so that you have an animation for going left. You can also flip the animation in the scene with the same result, but this is more straightforward. Import in the same way an image for the idle animation and the jump animation, which in this case are only one frame long. In the same way, we create a sprite for the platform as well. If you follow this tutorial with the same sprites, note that the platform is in the simplified platform folder. Now we will make the player object to set the player input. Change the name and give it the idle sprite. It doesn't really matter that much as we are going to change the animation manually. To make this work, I will also reset the animation when no key is pressed. Add the key down no key is pressed and add in the set sprite to set it to idle. Set animation speed to 0 and horizontal speed to 0 as well. Add the new event key down left and set the sprite to the walking animation for left. The animation speed to 0.5 and the horizontal speed to -5. For the right key we do exactly the same, only we now change the walking animation to the right and the horizontal speed to a positive 5. We can test our animation by dragging in the player object in room 1. Notice that the animation doesn't feel natural. To fix this we will set the set sprite to a relative frame so that it's looping based on the previous frame. To be able to set the gravity in your game we first need to have something that we can use as a floor, so first we'll make an object out of the platform. Get back to the room. You can scroll out with holding Ctrl and scrolling your mouse wheel. Click on the new object with holding the Alt key and draw the floor in the screen. We make a little platform as well. Great! All is set to set the gravity. First we'll set a variable in the player object to count the double jump. Create an create event and drag in an add variable and set the value to 0. Create a new step event and use a if object at place check. Select the platform. And in this check we don't care about the x value, so I set it on a relative. And the I value exactly on the same position as the I value of the player, so object player.i. Now we'll set the gravity force to 0. Be sure to connect it within the if object at place check. While setting the gravity force to 0 doesn't immediately stop the movement, so we need to also stop the vertical speed caused by the force. Set vertical speed to 0. And we set a jump variable back to 0, because when the player hits the ground, the double jump didn't happen at all. Now we add an else into this statement, because if the player is not on the floor, it means it is in the air. In that case, we set the gravity force to 0.4. Let's go back to the room, because I want to set the player always on top of the floor, so I'm going to create a new layer, instance layer, delete the player in the first layer, and drag the player object into the new layer. Okay, let's go back to the player to add some jumping. As we check all gravity functions in the step event, I want to set the jumping in the same event, so nothing is overriding itself without our doing. So first we'll drag in the if key press space, and we check not, because we want to have the gravity when we are jumping. Let's add a new block for the if key press space, and add in an if statement to check if the player isn't aimlessly jumping in the air. With a jump count, we check if that is less or equal than 1. If so, we allow the player to jump and set the jump count it by itself to +1 relative. Set the change sprite to jump and set its speed vertical to -15. You can tweak this number as you like. To make your game a bit more lively, you can import your own background or give the scene a nice background color. And to make it even more visible appealing, you can add the key into your scene. I just like to remind you that you need to make the key into an object to be able to drag it into the room. This was all for this week. I hope you liked this tutorial. If so, all support is welcome. Make more and enjoy more. This was Acreates. See you in the next video.